All right, set up. My desk was kind of a mess, so we moved over here. It is my anniversary, 6th anniversary. So I had these out and decided to take Rose out. I think that would set the mood a little bit. Anyway, this is the EVVA Dual. I've not got this in camera yet. It's got 12 sliders, 6 sliders at either side, as well as sidebars that they correspond with on either side. And works very smooth. This is an ICS padlock. The ICS took the place of the EVVA Dual. The EVVA Dual is no longer made. Quite a bit of a rarity. I suspect most of them are probably in collections that they are no longer manufactured. You can get them manufactured if you do have a key card ID or something like that, that they can remanufacture them. I actually have one up that was done that I purchased from that. Okay, so this is the picking of making sure everything is set up properly. I'm going to tap the camera here to make sure we're focused in. And we'll go after it. This is semi rehearsed. Six. Reset. And this has happened before. Got stuck. And I just messed up everything. Let's just start all over. Try to use a multi-pick to get back there towards the back there. Mainly for the left side, so let's just try to stick with the gym for now. Okay, looks like we got some isolation there.
I hope so, Emma.
Just check one more time. I think we might be good on the right side. So, usually I kind of struggle with the right. Sure, with both of them, actually. This side, the left side, it's that 6th pin that hides behind a low set. hope we get something here. So now 1 and 2 are high lifts, which makes this left side sort of easy, but it's that back one, like I said, is just really, really tricky. I woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning and I just sat down at the desk and I opened it, like I would say, under at least 2 minutes. It was pretty surprising and I couldn't replicate that. I was so frustrated after having done so, but also happy about it. And kept at it all day today. I was at it most of the day yesterday, and here we are. Okay, so 2's good. 1's not wanting to set yet. Hold on. 2's not good. Right. A lot of ping pong going on. A give and take. I gotta set 2 again. Four set. Five is set. Oh boy. This is the con of using wide tensioner. I think we may have lost everything on the right side. Or I'm on the left, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. two, ping pong, back and forth. Both high lifts. Multi-pick here. Multi-pick. Okay. Yeah, they're displaying. I got them both trapped now. Situation again. tells me the right side is not completely. Isolation there. One, two, and three are set. One, two, three. Rotation there. Really close. As soon as I say that, I set it back there and I think it drops and we're sitting 10-1, so. Here comes pin one again. Pin one comes pin two. Got it. Oh. Alright. Alright, 20 minutes in, that's a all right, let's not mess this up. Okay, so let's get this in frame. Awesome, finally on camera. We got the dual. I believe I promised Norlin I'd get this out to him. I think we're gonna do some trading or whatnot. Make sure he gets his hand on one of these. Are hard to get. Okay, so we got a clear open there. Where's that lighting? Okay, now it's not going to want to close because of the shackle. Which way? Yeah, so. Alright, so it's locked up. Alright, let's try to get this thing as quick as possible here. Alright, I'm using Justin McSlappy's tray here because I use that to propane, like the first half of it. It did help me out, or definitely helped me out. And these things are just awesome. So if you propane quite a bit, or if you're taking locks apart for whatever reason, they're really, really good to have. So, and if you're wondering about how to get your dual inside of a ICS of a padlock, you need this little piece right here. And they don't sell it separately, from what I understand. So just be aware of that. So, all right, so I don't have my C clip next to me. I don't think it's gonna work. Okay. C-clip remover, checking for time, we're good. All right, right there. All right. So be careful whenever you're taking this apart. You get this little, I think, key retaining like thing. It easily jumps out at me. It's not. There it is. And so that was that way. Turn upside down. Make sure you hold on to those sidebars here. And if you get stuck, I like to move the key in and out. It helps get out of those grooves there. All right, so let's first take our sidebars off. All right, and then I'm going to put this down. Nice and easy. I'm going to show you the shell. Let's focus on that. See those grooves? That's where the sliders, they actually sit outside of the plug and rest inside those grooves there. So, okay. Back of this stuff down here. Put your fingers over the top of those so they don't jump out on you. And we will I guess I have to get a shout out to Rain. He's been getting on me to get this slot pick for well, ever since my surgery, and I've tried a few times, and it's just hadn't worked out. And even now, healed up, I could definitely feel. I think I may have pushed myself just a little bit. It's been sore since I woke up from working on it yesterday. So, but I don't mind. I mean, no pain, no gain, and really. Probably be done with small aches and pains for the rest of my life. So. Okay. A little trick here. Boom. Alright, so the springs. Very, very tiny but long springs. Yeah, just loved having this Justin's pinning tray. Oh, it went flying. Hope we had that on. I'm sure we had that on video. Be more careful. And I will try to find that actually. I always gonna make a long video. On me. I don't know if it went to the drawer right here next to me or which one it is right here. Alrighty. Alright, so let's focus on the plug real quick. Pretty complex. Show you where the stay in focus here. Probably should have showed you before I gutted it. But those springs go in the holes right there, and there's a small notch or arm or whatever you protrusion that rests on top of that to make those sliders sprung. There's a larger nodule that's on the inside that allows the key to manipulate it to their respective heights and open the lock. Of course, we manipulate those larger nodules with picks. Okay, so here we are. I'm kind of looking through the camera here. As you can see, one true gate and two false. Oh boy. One true and two false. My setup is a bit weird. I think, I don't know if you can see the false gate on that. Hold on. There you go. If I do this at more of an angle. That was a devil. Now, what's harder, the ICS or this? That's up in the air. I want to go with the dual. I mean, the dual was pretty tough. I remember hating the ICS when I first opened it, though. So, I do have another one, and I plan on picking it at some point. Let's check out those sidebars. First is going to be the left side, which is actually the right side, because we turned it upside down. Here we go. More focus. The springs there. One spring went missing on me yesterday, and that was not fun. I had to go hunting for it. Finally found it. All right. And so that's the EVVA Dual. Very cool. Very cool pick. All right. Thanks, guys, for watching. And I'm going to call this video right here. And I'm going to try to find that lost spring. So, all right. Take care.